We are following on from the previous video where we created latched function keys for routing talkback to specific mix buses using toggle operators and parallel parameters. Then we created a way to talk to multiple mix buses at the same time. But some console users want to be sure of only talking to one mix bus at a time, still with the function keys working with a latching behavior. To achieve this, we need to first disable all other talkback assignments before activating the one we wish for. For that, we can use wait times in the macro action settings. Using wait times will allow you to determine the order of events. Find the macro we created before called mix talkback latch. Disable it and open it for editing. This is where the mixbus function keys assign the mix to talk group 8 and enable talkback. Let's create a new action to clear all the talk group assignments first. Open capture and on the other screen, look at the talkback group assign screen. Disable mix 1. Enable then disable stereo A. Enable and disable matrix 1. Then import those into the list of actions. Edit the mix off action and set the mix parameter to all. And do the same for the stereo and matrix action parameters too. These are the actions we want to occur first, but the actions don't follow any order, such as from top to bottom. We need to manually order them by using wait times. Open the action for assigning the mix and apply a wait time of 0.1 second. So the assignment will occur after clearing all the previous assignments. Open the talk back on action and apply a wait time of 0.2 seconds. So this will be the last action to occur. Enable a macro and test. At a first glance, it seems to be working well. Press a new function key and the previous one cancels. However, if we try to cancel them all, we get stuck. We are always left with one assignment. To overcome this problem, we can use conditions in the macros. If the mix is already assigned when the function key is pressed, then just clear all the assignments. However, if the mix is not assigned when the function key is pressed, follow the actions we already programmed. So, disable the macro to edit it. And capture the mix assign switching off. And import it as a condition. Just like the trigger, set the mix parameter to 1 to 12 and enable parallel so it applies in the same way to mixes 1 to 12. Now duplicate this macro and edit the name to mix talkback latch all off. Edit the condition to be sure it only works when an already assigned mix is pressed. So set the condition's value to on. Now edit the actions. Delete or disable the actions for mix toggle and for talkback on. So we are just left with the assign off actions. Enable the macros and test again. At last, it is working as we wish. And you've been able to see how editing certain functions within macros can have a knock-on effect and create the need for additional programming. We have to think carefully about the process, but it's worth it in the end to get the exact workflow customization you require to have a better mixing experience. I'm sure you can imagine other use cases for these function keys. So don't miss my other videos about Genius Lab to learn more about using macros with faders, user-defined keys, and more. See you again soon.